Hey guys, Dr. Prometheus here, back with the Battle of Vicksburg. We're holding around, what is this, Champions Hill and Jackson Road. Just trying to hold them out of, well, the road into Vicksburg here. They are actually going to come at us. That is very strange that they would do that. This artillery, though, is becoming an issue. I think grabbing that artillery is a good idea. Now, they're holding us here, but I think they're going to regret that. The 1st Brigade is going to come through. So, this is the 13th Corps. I think she's going to get ate up. Once the end of the day, we're going to kind of put our stronger units in the middle again. We're going to reconstitute our force. Kind of hope for the best. We are going to get some skirmishers on the flanks, like we've been doing. These 12 pounders are doing work. These howitzers are hitting the enemy. If we can grab these and send them up here, this further allows us to do some work. No advances on our right. They're still getting in place. Kind of figured that would be the case. We do this, we can't deploy skirmishers, and that is an issue I don't like, but hey, it happens. Because you have the 1st Brigade here, the 13th Corps, trying to get in here, skirmishers on their flanks. The 2nd Brigade in the green. We have Buford here trying to repel off the first part. Stanley's 12-pound field of guns are wreaking havoc on the 1st Brigade as they're just melting away. As you can see, Union blue uniforms just all over the field. We need Tigman to kind of hold as best as he can. Holding slowly but surely here. 1st Brigade, the 13th Corps here, another one. This is the 12th Division. It's getting hit, and here we go. We've melted one more. Let's put skirmishers out. We can't put skirmishers because they're still firing. And there she goes. She is gone. So our center continues to hold here. As our artillery rains out, the only issue that we have is we cannot take down this artillery for the life of us. The 10th Artillery Corps in Burbridge's section. Maybe if these are three-inch howitzers? We're going to deploy some skirmishers against Lee's detachment. We're going to see if we can't break. This unit. This one came from there. Can't come up and at least do something. I want to cover ourselves to get this so we can move it back to the hill here. It's going to be more advantageous if we can get those cannons. I will waste 200 men here on this fight if I need to. So artillery, our actual intelligence here that there was a unit is incorrect. So that can happen. We're going to deploy skirmishers out from here. If I could get this one to retreat, we can recover some cannons here. 3-inch ordnance rifles, yes. No, our intelligence was correct. There is a unit right here. Skirmishers back. Let's pull all of our skirmishers back. They're still going off our flanks here. So we got some 3-inch ordnance rifles. Get some more off the back end. If we can get a couple 3-inch ordnance rifles here to start hitting the 10th Artillery Division, it would be great. Because this is just not going to be acceptable. Just allowing them to shell my troops. Guns here. I thought there was. Did we destroy the rest of them? Let's pull the skirmishers back and then pick them up. Limbering, counter battery fire. Okay, it's got to come from the division commander down to the brigade commander and down to the detachment. It's only 4 guns, but it's something. Are you firing now? Move this detachment out anyway, so once we recover these guns, put them up here. I'm gonna move this one into this spot, and this one will be up on our flanks. We just don't have the intelligence to see that unit there. Do that, and I want you to do counter battery fire. Okay, we're gonna move out this unit. It's gonna be on the flank. This unit is gonna go here. It's a little touchy. There it goes. I think this attaches to that one. Okay, so that's the reorganization there. We're good there. They've been hit with 300. That's fine. That's fine. I have a feeling I'm gonna have to sit there. Okay, so that ends there. I'm looking to see if there's any, there's a hill structure like right here. I think it'll work there. Okay, we're kind of spun around. I don't see anything over here. It looks like they constitute themselves more towards the north, which is kind of confusing at times on why they would do that. Okay, so we're here. Since they gave us more room out in front, I would like to extend this to this crossroad, but they would just extend outside of me. I think this is probably the best bet for right now. If I had parapets, that would be even better. One thing that would be cool, not gonna lie, is being able to upgrade your defenses during the night like this, if you're in a defensive battle, to parapets. Like, that would be cool, not gonna lie. Let's mix with the 2nd Brigade. The only thing with this position, there's no assisting there. Maybe there is. here. Shift everyone over one. Reynolds. Pull skirmishers in. Deploy skirmishers. You set them in. I have nothing in front of us. I'm not sure if that's true. Oh, that's the brigade itself. Okay. Let's pull those back. Let's see if we can grab those guns. If we can grab those guns and come over here, that'd be ideal. Can we hit that second brigade there? Thank you. Oh, whoops. This time I gave those orders. Okay, I'm gonna put them here. Okay, I'm gonna pull back these skirmishers. Okay, if I can pull this back and put it here, we can put some more fire on them. Okay, from their camp here at the middle road, back here at their portion, we're starting to see them come back into view. We get these men a counter battery fire now up on our ridge behind us. Unit forces are coming at us. We're going to see if we can grab some of these cannons and move them back behind the lines. If we can, it would be a godsend. Although it's four guns. Four guns is four guns. Three-inch ordnance rifles, let's go. Right here, baby. No, I need you. A direct route. Like this. Okay, they're out of ammo. redeploy skirmishers. Gonna redeploy skirmishers. Second Division Artillery is going to kill us there. Bring back those skirmishers. Same thing here. Back. There's nothing to shoot at, so fire at will. They've moved their batteries off to the right. Fortunately for me, that just doesn't bode well for my ability to come over here. Let's see. We're still getting our forces together. I'll be ready when they do attack. They're setting up for an attack. If I was them, I would be hitting me on all fronts right now. With everything. And this is our only scouted unit here. We aren't getting any casualties on these units. We need to force an engagement. They're gonna eat us alive if we just allow them to deal damage to me like this. Thank you. well. We got a few, that's why. Because we're too busy waiting for stuff that, of course, we got a few. If they come at me, I will gladly pull my skirmishers back. Looks like they're about to. Or they're backing up. I got two isolated units over here. Counterattack now. Second brigade's only got 1,600 men. They only got 1,700. You have 18 and 14. Nope, this is a general assault by them. Put out the men. Mississippi Rifles. At least it looks like one. They backed off it. Fix this salient because the game doesn't do a very good job of actually forcing smart things to occur. There it goes. Farnsworth. Farnsworth is specifically being targeted here. Farnsworth's broke. There's only 5 men left. Farnsworth is wounded in action. Using skirmishers in this manner? Ingenious. We aren't in any sort of protection here. Pushing their right as best as we can. To stall this frontal assault now. Reynolds is getting whipped right now. He's not going to be able to hold. Let's move him back. We will deploy skirmishers. We're going to keep on pushing up like this. We've whipped one brigade there. Turn around. We're going to keep on pushing up like this. Against this one, it's isolated. There's another one that's whipped. Hey, Pemberton, can you get off the front lines here, bro? Okay, Okay, we've delayed that. Let's pull back our skirmishers from here. We could refocus our men. Okay, pull our Napoleons back here. Attack that unit. Okay, so we are going to come back to here. We're gonna bring these cannons back like this. And we are gonna roll back this way. I want you, while you're firing, to move back. Okay, now they're hitting us on the front side. Starting to see, I can't hit them there, so let's put out skirmishers. Back now. Pull back our skirmishers. Good left flank attack there. Okay. And that is a huge rout of Union forces there. Skirmishers. Showing a minor defeat, however, I don't think that's necessarily true. Pull up right side. Pull up right side. Move these cannons off the line. Another unit breaking. Let's go. Since we can't hit them, we're gonna come out and hit them with that. I'm gonna come out like this. Get very good counterattack on our right. And another unit routes. See more reinforcements in their center come. Is this our chance? I think this is our chance to completely counterattack the enemy. So I think we have it held over here. Let's give them iron discipline. Thank you. press the attack. Another unit routes for them. Don't have a feud right now. I kind of need you to not have a feud right now. Alright. Let's go crush these two units. Come on. Why aren't you going up the hill? Oh, that last bit is actually up a hill, that's why. Come on. Rally. What do you stop? Stop your orders. Please. No. Fire this way. Bro, why aren't you out here? This is a general counterattack, not a half-ass counterattack. This is a full general counterattack right now. Why would you remotely go there? That makes no sense. Stop! Stop your orders. Ooh, we're starting to see some issues on the field. Like ammo and whatnot. Are killing me right now. Button's about to get whipped. We need to move him back. And where is... I don't know where Vaughn's going. Vaughn's going... He's marching back to Virginia, I guess. Two more commanders, Cumming and Barton. Moore is now losing men. So it's this section of Moore. He has broke. There's more skirmishers than anything. Lee is losing men. Move him back to the comfort of the lines. Conflict takes over this spot. doesn't have any ammo. Storm and thunder here at Vicksburg. The men are running out of ammunition. We are pressing the attack against the Union. Their forces are breaking slowly but surely. The counterattack is doing well, boys. We're back to indecisive. Another unit broke. There goes another unit. Third Brigade's getting hit here now. Is losing men. However, we are pressing the attack and we are winning the attack at least. More of this. Stop. Give them the stop order. Morris standing fast here. End of day, darkness has fallen. Our men are scattered all over the field. Stevenson's going to come up Brown's Hill. How much does Union still have on the field? We still have 15,000 against our 21,000. We're going to go up the Brown's Field with this. Bourne's division is going to hold the center. And Loring's division is going to be out here. Trumbull's division with its artillery is going to be situated here. Vicksburg garrison will be on our right. This section, you're going to go back here. With this section, you're going to come up around and flank from the right. Green is stuck behind enemy lines, but sometimes that's how it is. Buford is breaking off the field. We'll see if we can rally him. The Cav wants no part of this. Sweep down on the Cav. And we just drove. He just broke. So a minor defeat. We're assaulting fields. We're going to make sure there's no one there first. Looks like there was at one point. We are struggling with ammo. Ammo count is an issue. There is a unit here. There is a unit coming behind us. Reynolds is wounded. Can I get him to... There it goes. Barton went true. We kind of knew that was going to happen. I want you to get out of the way of this unit. So you can fire. Okay, they're all off the field. They're all off the field. I think we have won the day now. The game still thinks we're in a major defeat. Might still be someone over here. Since this is a point, defended my position well. It's a bloody battle at this point. Units lost 30,000. We have lost 11,000. So we've lost a third of our force, and he's nearly lost all of his force on the field. He's lost more than 50% of his men on the field. I would imagine that Grant will retreat after this battle, and we will have to replenish. It's going to take us a long while. We held on Champion's Hill. Very bloody. See over here, we counterattacked off to our right. with our defenses here. We counterattacked, retook Ratliff Road. Once the Union started theirs, we just pretty much pushed into their offensive while we were holding our left, and then we just came off the hill and pushed them. Pushed them off their hill. If I could have picked anywhere else to defend, it likely would have been Brown's Hill. But we knew the Union was already likely dug in at Brown's Hill. So we dug in around our 2 points here. If I had that other section of with the Johnston, I would have looped around and I would have grabbed also Ratliff Hill in my Ratliff Road in my defensive position. So I think that's what I'm going to start doing, is if I take a defensive position, it has to be around objectives, if that makes sense. I have to charge those. I'll stop. He should run off the field. I don't see him standing here and fighting this. We're going to get in battle lines. With artillery cover. sneaking in the back. Really? Shoop just surrendered. Right before the retreat. Okay, so 30,000 gone for Grant. He wanted to fight to the last man on the field, and he got it to the last man. 94% casualty rate. Getting absolutely destroyed out here. As for commanders, Pemberton gets a point of experience, I think. Stevenson, Bowen, Loring, Tremble out here. Reynolds, Barton, and Cummings were... And Cumming was injured. Bowen, that's Green Cockrell, fine. Farnsworth was wounded. On the Smith, we had some... Moore was wounded. I thought we had one that was KIA. Shoop is missing. Maybe he'll come back to us. So I guess we did not have anyone that was KIA, just a wounded. For Grant, Logan, MacArthur, and Quinby, Boomer, Reed, and Maurice, Smith, the 17th Corps were all wounded. Blair Jr. was killed out of the 2nd Division of the 15th Corps. So was Captain McClernden. Okay. Ewing was wounded. Buckland. There, Captain Barton, or Burton, of the 1st Division Artillery. It's everything out of the Sherman's Corps. 17th Corps is McPherson. Now this is Major General McClernden. Brigadier General Carr was killed. Morton and Benton wounded out of his division. Out of Hovey's, Slack and Abercrombie were wounded. And in Smith's, Burbridge was wounded. So that was it. Big, big defeat for the Union here. Grant is not going to be able to take Vicksburg, even though they did cut us off supply. We are securing the other side of the river, so hopefully we can get something going in that. Pemberton, though. Pemberton. Standing tall in the face of adversity. It is a very, very difficult battle in that, but we did pull it off. And we didn't pull it off by sitting either. We pulled it off by sitting, counterattacking, picking our places, and essentially exploiting any weakness that they gave us. Maybe delaying my attack until that second or third major wave that they tried to hit us with exhausted themselves. But if I would have came down when Sherman was there, we likely would have been wiped from the field. when Sherman's corps came on and destroyed our right. He would have swooped right in my center and just crushed it. Because we were running out of ammo as that battle was going on. We did lose some guns. I think they were 12-pound Napoleons. But at least we hold here. In that case, it is a replenishment time here at Vicksburg. Department of Mississippi's here. Army of Western Louisiana will be able to come on the other side. Gardner is reinforcing. We'll have Texas up here, and then eventually we will have a defensive perimeter set up. I'm going to keep Arkansas here. We're going to put that one at Smith. So at least we hold a portion of Louisiana in Arkansas. And we just need to force them north. Next battle is probably going to be around either Nashville. Or maybe if... who's the commander of the Potomac right now? Is it Halleck? I think Halleck is over here. If Halleck wants to come across the river, I will more than accommodate him. But I think he is going to sit on the other side of the river and bide his time. I don't think he wants to come at us. We have these forts that we have to take. We lost sight of the enemy unit that was over here. I do not know if they retreated way up north, but the look of it is that they are not here. So we're just going to replenish from here and take these two forts, Pulaski and Walker, and that will help us secure Savannah. The District of Florida is going to come over here to Jacksonville and take this and Fernandina. So we'll secure Fernandina. And then we'll consolidate this army and likely come up and join the fight around Montgomery with this army. And just move everything over there. So at least we'll have some kind of stopgap in the middle of Columbus and maybe be able to counterattack through Corinth. But remember, not all plans survive enemy contact. And we have this issue down here in Pensacola. So... if we get this win here, maybe we can shift this army more down towards Vicksburg and we can clean up at least some part of Mobile. But that will end your episode. The Battle of Vicksburg, we took it. We whipped Grant. He's on the retreat. We'll see where he goes from here. I think he's going to go south. So we still have to deal with this. Army of the 19th Corps here. We're reinforcing the Army of Eastern Louisiana with some units. Once we get those units in, maybe we can take New Orleans and kind of hold here. We got a lot of forts that we got to take back as well to kind of secure that area. But we are slowly rolling, that's for sure. We're slowly rolling. So not a lot of things we can construct. Let's look at the like supply lines, maps. Here's the map. So here's the front lines currently. We have them cut off in Mississippi, but Grant's supply line through the Mississippi River is still intact. Particularly the supply line through here that goes through Jackson, and it's sporadic when it comes through Corinth. It looks like Corinth is about right here, but then we of course got this fighting in North Carolina, this issue. So our intelligence, we don't have great intelligence down in Florida. is trade support right now. And that will be that. All right, guys. Go ahead and leave a like below, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time. Later.